Liz Cambage fights against unfair salaries in men versus women's basketball. Athletes are thought to live the life of luxury. They buy the best cars, yachts, and show off their luxurious lifestyle every day on social media. But we have to look more carefully at how much they actually earn. And here, you'll be surprised that the conditions for men and women are extremely different. Sounds weird. We fight for equal rights in all spheres of life, for men and women. But majority of us overlook how the best players of the NBA make 200 times more than some of the best players in the WNBA. There currently is a big movement in the NBA to equalize the conditions, but we believe it will be very hard to make the salaries in these two leagues the same. Today, we'll look at Liz Cambage, her words about salaries in women's basketball, and her methods to fight for equal compensation. How much does Liz Cambage earn? Her base salary for the Las Vegas Aces is $221,450 a year. That is the top salary in the WNBA, so there is not one single person in the league who gets a dollar more. There are some players who get the same salary. For example, Duana Bonner from Connecticut Sun, Diana Taurasi and Brittany Griner from the Phoenix Mercury, Sue Bird from Seattle Storm, and Elena Del Don from Washington Mystics. These are the top players in the league. The organization would be glad to pay them more, as they are the legends of women's basketball. But it's illegal to raise their salaries. There is a salary cap for each team. In current season, any WNBA organization may pay up to $1,339,000 to 12 players of the team. If you divide it into 12 players, you'll see that the average top salary should be around $110,000. But the teams sometimes pay even less to their rookies, so the average is slightly less than $90,000. And that sounds devastating for top women basketball players. Liz Cambage earns a little in the United States, but she signs contracts with teams from all over the world to gain more revenue during her off-season time. That's why you can see her playing in China and in Australia each year. This is actually the most popular ways for American women basketball players to get more money. They typically play in Turkey, China, and Russia. Are there salary caps in the NBA? Obviously, there are salary caps in sports. So NBA is not an exception. But the salary cap is around $109 million, and that is nearly 100 times larger than the WNBA. That's why NBA stars are able to claim much bigger salaries. We already stated that Liz Cambage gets less than $250,000 a year. Russell Westbrook from the Washington Wizards gets over $41 million annually. That's 180 times more than Liz Cambage gets from the Las Vegas Aces. Chris Paul from the Phoenix Suns gets exactly the same salary as Russell Westbrook. There are 129 players in the NBA who get over $10 million of base salary. There are only 9 basketball players in the NBA who receive a lower salary than Liz Cambage, and that's devastating to see what a huge gap there is between men and women basketball salaries. Why is there such a big gap? Well, the NBA games are watched by millions. The top players are real celebrities. Nearly any American can tell you who are the best NBA players. Their dunks and spectacular ball control skills make thousands of people each week come to stadiums and support their favorite teams. For the WNBA, things are much worse. Women typically can't dunk. There are only 2 players who do that on a regular basis, Candace Parker and Brittany Griner. Statistics says on average, 1.34 million people watch every NBA game. This figure includes the fans in the stadiums and viewing on TV. For the WNBA, the average viewers is 205,000 per game. That's about 6 times less than the NBA. But why are salaries 200 times smaller then? Experts say things must get better over time. They recall when the NBA started developing, salaries were very low and players couldn't rely on the payment to maintain for their families. Things changed after 25 seasons. When teams started getting more revenue from broadcasting rights and endorsement deals. The WNBA has existed a quarter of a century, so now it's time to grow the popularity of the association and pay more to players. They should also attract more private investors who are interested in sports. Otherwise, they will have a long way to the top. One more way for the WNBA players to earn more money is to sign contracts with teams overseas. Many players of women's basketball in the U.S. play for Turkish, Russian, Chinese, and Australian teams. They manage to earn up to $1 million during a half year of off-season in the WNBA. This is not an easy way, but it helps top players build income and stay in the U.S. for the next season to play for their team. Every one of us can also make the WNBA more successful just by watching and attending their games live. Your support counts.